Hi everyone, my name is Ben, and here in front of us today we have the iPhone 13 mini and the iPhone SE. These are Apple's two budget offerings in 2023. Let's check them out and decide which one of these is more worth your money. Now, right off the bat, you can see that the iPhone 13 mini looks far more modern than the iPhone SE. The iPhone SE employs the same design from the iPhone 8 in 2017. Now, it's been over 5 years since the iPhone 8 came out. And I would dare say that the iPhone 6 from 2014 is essentially the same design as this iPhone SE. So you're going to get comments using the iPhone SE. Wow, why are you using such an old phone? Dang, that thing is old. When are you going to replace it? All that sort of stuff you're going to hear. But what's interesting about these two phones is despite their difference in appearance, they have the exact same chip on the inside with Apple's A15 Bionic. Now let's just open up a few apps. I closed out all the apps, so there's nothing in memory right now. So we can just open these and check them out. So I'm gonna open up the App Store, and those open up at the same time, essentially. Let's open up One Football. Essentially the same, dare I say the SE is a little bit quicker. And then let's open up News. So yeah, even in that comparison, it looked like the SE was slightly faster. Let's go back and just check the RAM, loading an app from memory. Comes right up. So these are very, very quick phones. And I would say that you'll be set on either one of these phones for 4 or 5 years, probably, in terms of performance. I use iPhones from 4 years ago. I've used an iPhone XS, an iPhone X, and those are still completely usable now. So outside of that difference, of course, you have a completely different display technology on these two phones. On the iPhone 13 mini, you're getting an OLED display, while on the iPhone SE here, you have an LCD. And what's different about that, I think most of all, is how good the colors look. Now, on camera, from what you see, it's really hard to tell this, but the iPhone 13 mini has much nicer blacks. You can see just in this widget here, the pure blacks are just beautiful on the 13 mini. And overall, the saturation is excellent on the SE. But if you compare them side by side, it's pretty obvious that the 13 mini has the nicer display. Plus, you get so much more screen real estate on the iPhone 13 mini. What's fascinating to me is this is essentially the same screen size as the old iPhone 6 to 8 Plus, which were 5.5 inches, while the SE is at 5.4 inches. So those old phones that were so big, that same screen size is right here in your hands. So in terms of ingesting content, in terms of looking at the news, watching videos, the 13 mini is a much nicer place to be than the iPhone SE. So already the iPhone 13 mini has a lot of points for it. Another thing to consider with these two phones when you're looking at them is the iPhone 13 mini starts with the 120 gigabyte configuration for $599, while the SE is $429 for the 64 gigabyte configuration. So you're getting that additional storage for the same money that you're paying. So that's a serious consideration to think of if you're using this phone for as long as it will last in terms of this chip and the software updates. The next biggest thing on these phones, and you can see just on the back how different the cameras are, the iPhone SE has the same sensor, as far as I'm aware, as the iPhone 8. Now, it looks a lot better than the iPhone 8 because of software processing and how nice the A15 chip is in processing the photo data. But the iPhone 13 mini has the same camera sensor as the iPhone 12 Pro Max and the entire iPhone 13 lineup. I think the Pro and the Pro Max use a different sensor, but the 13 and the 13 mini share a sensor along with the 12 Pro Max. And you can see here, the output is different on these two phones. Now, I would dare say that the SE here on the right produces a nicer picture just taking this brick. However, if we look down here, you can see an interesting thing about the way that they process the photo. The 13 mini collected a lot more light. So you can see that the light down there is a lot nicer when I look at my foot. Meanwhile, on the SE, the picture down there is a lot darker and a lot less nice to look at. Let's go over and check out another camera sample. And you can see the same deal here in terms of the light. The 13 mini is far brighter of a photo than the SE. And if we zoom in here into maybe a darker point, like the back of this car, you can barely see the back of the car on the SE, while you can see it relatively clearly here on the iPhone 13 mini. Now that's a pretty significant difference. Let's go back and look at the brick here on the side of this building. You can see it looks pretty bright. It looks solid on the 13 mini. And if we open it up on the SE, you can barely even make it out. So there are some real differences here on that rear camera sensor, and you're gonna notice that difference in real life without a doubt. The 13 mini just produces far better photos. Let's look at this indoor shot finally, and that just continues the theme that I'm talking about in terms of light. Now, the 13 mini here is just collecting a lot more data, and it just produces a nicer picture overall. And you can see the detail here on the back of the couch is far nicer. So the iPhone 13 mini, if you care at all about the photos that you're taking, I think is easily going to be worth that money difference. Another thing to consider on top of that is battery life. Now, I don't have the specs of the battery size on both of these, but I've used both of them. And I know that the 13 mini gets a nicer, it's better on the battery, it lasts longer. So you're going to be better off with the 13 mini in that regard. Something to consider though is the iPhone SE has historically been cheaper to replace with Apple. Right now it's sitting at $49 to replace the battery versus $69. So that is something to consider long term. The battery and parts are cheaper on the SE, and if you break your screen, it's the exact same story. It's just a lot cheaper to get parts for the SE. Last of all, I think we just have to comment on the overall day-to-day life on these two phones. The performance is basically the same as we went over, but using these two phones is just a completely different story. It feels primitive, it feels ancient to be on the iPhone SE. I personally don't think Touch ID is worth all of the love that it gets from the community. I think that it's nice, and I definitely appreciate being able to just unlock my phone sometimes without even looking at it. I can have it pulling out of my pocket and it can be unlocked just because I clicked that button. But the Face ID has essentially been perfected by the time that it's reached with the iPhone 13 mini. You almost don't even have to think about it. You can be at a pretty extreme angle and still unlock the phone. So I would say, even if you love the Touch ID sensor, give the 13 mini a shot. I think the Face ID has come very far, and it can even work with a face mask at this point. So I would say the iPhone SE, it's a nice phone and it can do a lot. But if you have any sort of liberty in getting the 13 mini for more money, it's well worth that money. Considering that the 120 gigabyte model of the SE is $479 versus $599 on this phone, it's going to be worth your money, especially to spend that. Now, there is the elephant in the room with the SE, is that a lot of carriers are going to provide it for a lot cheaper than $429. You can get it on for free probably from a lot of the smaller carriers and with some serious deals with the SE. And I would say, you know, if you're getting the SE for $200 or essentially, you know, a steal of a deal in comparison to the 13 mini, it's going to do the job. But the 13 mini, as we've been over in this video, is just a far more modern and far better phone to live with. So spend the money if you can at all. I hope you all enjoyed this video. Please let me know below your thoughts and how your experiences have been with these two phones. Thanks for your time. Bye.